Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Lucy Amanio, SHO Year 1, Department of Pediatrics on Ward 16A. So I'm presenting MJ, an 8-year-old boy from Chinawa, whose next of kin is the mother. And he was admitted on our ward on the 17th of August, 2017. He presented with a 3-day history of cough, chest pain, difficulty in breathing for 2 days, and fever. The patient is a known patient of sickle cell disease and was well until 3 days prior to admission, when he developed a dry cough that was associated with chest pain and difficulty in breathing. The chest pain was worse when sitting upright and mildly relieved by sitting while leaning backwards. It was not clear whether the chest pain was worse on turning and changing position. There was also a history of high-grade fevers not associated with convulsions, chills, or rigors. In the review of systems, the patient had a history of yellow eyes and mild abdominal pain and vomiting. In the musculoskeletal system, there was pain in both the upper and lower limbs. In the cardiovascular system, the patient had a history of palpitations, easy fatigability, but no history of lower limb swelling. Other systems like the CNS and genitourinary system were unremarkable. In the past medical history, the patient had been diagnosed with sickle cell disease at 4 months when he presented to hospital with a history of painful swollen hands and feet. And he's had several admissions since then due to various reasons. He regularly attends the sickle cell clinic, takes folic acid and Fansida, but is not on hydroxyurea. Past surgical history, the patient has had several blood transfusions. By several, I mean more than 15. And the first was at 4 months. Other history, family social. This is a firstborn of 2 children. The younger child is 5 years old and is well. And that child has a different father. So in summary, I've presented an 8-year-old male sickler who's been regularly attending the sickle cell clinic, is on Fansida and folic acid, but not on hydroxyurea, and was admitted with a 3-day history of dry cough associated with chest pain relieved by leaning back, and difficulty in breathing for 2 days, and history of high-grade fever. The child also had a history of yellowing of eyes, mild abdominal pain, vomiting, pain in both the upper and lower limbs, palpitations, and easy fatigability. So when this child was examined, we found a sick-looking child who was a febrile, the temperature was 37.3, had moderate to severe pallor, a tinge of jaundice, no lymphadenopathy, had a rash which was healing, was saturating at 80%. Anthropometry, we found the weight was 18 kilograms. It was hard to do the height because the child was really, really ill. The mark was 13 centimeters and it was in the green region. Respiratory system, the child was in severe distress with intercostal recession, was tachypneic with a respiratory rate of 64 breaths per minute. The right side of the chest was moving less with respiration. On palpation, there was no tenderness, but the trachea was slightly deviated to the left. There was a stony dull percussion note on the right side, especially in the inframammary region. Reduced breath sounds on the right side, especially in the anterior infraclavicular region. And in the inframammary region, the breath sounds were absent. There was a bit of bronchial breathing heard on the left side of the chest. Cardiovascular, the child was tachycardic with a pulse rate of 154 breaths per minute. The pulse was of large volume. Child had a hyperactive pericardium. The apex beat was in the 8th intercostal space, anterior axillary line. Heart sounds 1 and 2 were heard, and there was a gallop rhythm at that time. Parabdomen, the child had a tender hepatomegaly of 4 centimeters below the costal margin. The spleen was not palpable, and neither were other masses or organomegaly. CNS exam and other systems were unremarkable. So from the history and exam findings, we had an impression of sickle cell anemia with severe pneumonia complicated by empyema thoracis, acute chest syndrome with empyema thoracis, severe anemia in heart failure, acute chest syndrome with a possible pleural effusion, and differential diagnoses of pulmonary TB and malaria. We went ahead to investigate the child. A blood slide showed no malaria parasites. We did grouping and cross-matching. We did an aspiration on the right side of the chest and got about 250 mils of thick pus, which was sent for pouch and sensitivity. We did chest x-rays and a CBC. This is very unclear, but I don't know if you can see anything, but those are the chest x-rays before drainage on the 18th and after drainage on the 25th. If you look carefully, you'll be able to see something. So our final diagnosis at that time was sickle cell anemia with severe pneumonia complicated by pyomathorasis, ruling out pulmonary TB. So these are some of the investigation results that we have as of now. Initially on the 17th, the child had a leukocytosis of 23.7 with a neutrophilia of 19 and an HB of 5.1. Over the subsequent days, we saw that the leukocytosis worsened to 39.5 and so did the neutrophilia. And the HB improved to 7.5 after transfusion. The pleural tap was done on the 17th, but we only managed to get results today. And these are preliminary results. The gram stain showed gram-positive cocci. But the culture, there's been no bacterial growth yet. Other tests included a BS, which showed no malaria parasites. That's it. So how have you been managing this child? The child has been on oxygen therapy, IV ceftriaxone 1.5 grams once a day for 5 days, IV cloxacillin, IV metronidazole, azithromycin tablets, oral morphine, bisacodyl, paracetamol, and chest physiotherapy. Child has been blowing an improvised balloon, which is a glove. So what's our way forward? Currently, we are investigating the child for pulmonary TB. We've requested for ZN staining. We're also waiting for the culture of the aspirate, and we're going to do a Mantoux test. And we have also sent for blood cultures. And the chest tube was reinserted yesterday. However, it's not draining, so we are hoping to be reinserted. We're waiting for the cardiothoracic surgeons to review. Thank you.